Garland Tucker supported Tom Tillis back in 2014, even donated to his campaign. But the Raleigh Republican says North Carolina's junior senator hasn't lived up to his campaign promises.
Tucker says he's disappointed in Tillis over two major issues, immigration and government spending.
It's tough for politicians to say no to spending, but my answer to that is I'm not a politician, and it won't be tough for me to say no.
You can't really say that anymore, though.
Well, I think I could probably say it, Ed, that I'm certainly not a politician as far as my career goes.
Tucker says Tillis hasn't done the job when it comes to cutting entitlement programs.
That farm bill did not have any work requirements in it. It had no ability to reduce the reliance on food stamps, and I would not have voted for that bill. I think Tillis made a mistake in voting for that.
How significant a cut would you want to see in something like SNAP benefits?
Well, I would vote for any substantial cut.
Senator Tillis has voted with the president roughly 95% of the time. But Tucker says Tillis's conservative voting record is weak.
The three major rating agencies, the conservative groups, that's the Heritage Foundation, Freedom Works, and Club for Growth, they all rate senators. If you average the ratings, which are 0 to 100, 100 being conservative, 0 being liberal, Senator Tillis is at 51%. That's kind of, I would say, that's a half a conservative. And I think North Carolina Republicans and independents who will be voting in this primary want a more conservative voice.
Tucker wrote an op-ed back in 2016 describing Donald Trump as a flawed candidate. His first choice was Scott Walker, but he wrote that Trump was still a better choice than Hillary Clinton. Today, Tucker says he is entirely on board with the Trump presidency.
When I look at his policies, filter out the noise and the tweets and the personal lifestyle, filter all that out, but look at his policies, it's right out of the Reagan-Thatcher playbook.
Tucker says he expects the GOP primary will cost between $5 and $6 million. He says if he's elected, he'll serve just a single term in the U.S. Senate. In Raleigh, I'm Bill O'Neill, WXII 12 News.